Assalamu alaikum. My beloved students, how are you doing today? Hope you all are doing well by the kindness of Allah the Exalted. Alhamdulillah, I am also fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIEVS Home School after Eid vacation. This is Wahid Noor, Assistant Teacher of Islamic Studies, National Ideal English Version School, Day Shift. Today I am going to conduct the class of Islamic Studies for class 5. And before starting our class, I would like to gratitude to those students who are watching our all classes through the YouTube channel, and according to the classes they are performing their all HW and also submitting to the teacher. My dear students, today our topic is discussion of chapter 5, page 108 to 110. It means 3 pages, 108 to 110, and this is lecture number 11, and there is also HW number 11. My beloved students, before the Eid vacation I taken the class, and that was the last class of the chapter 4, and I told you after Eid vacation I will take the from chapter 5. So today is the first class from the chapter 5, and chapter 5, in chapter 5 a lot of information. If I say in every sentence there is one kind of information, so what I written it's not enough in that pages, but you have to read your book again and again. For example, today we will start from that pages, chapter 5, page number 108 109 and 110. If you see properly, then you can realize how many sentences are there. So how you can gather in your memory? So I will advise to you, you read your textbook all the lines again and again, and you by using the finger. For example, when you will read like this, by using the finger you will read like this, and not only one time, more than 3 times you have to read, then you can understood what he has said. But I picked up in the pages in the paper only which sentences are important, I think that sentences I picked up here, but left rest of all sentences what I didn't pick in the pages you have to read. Okay, my dear students, so first of all we introduce the sentences, introductory sentences about the prophets and messengers. What was their characteristics, why they came in the world, why Almighty Allah selected them as the prophet and messenger. This type of introductory sentences I collected, and all these sentences you will get in your book, page number 108. So first of all, here said Almighty Allah sent prophets, rasuls through ages for guidance of mankind. Students, this sentence also can be one question. Why Almighty Allah sent prophets and rasuls? Then you will write Almighty Allah sent prophets and rasuls through ages for guidance of mankind. And then prophets and rasuls were all great men and ideal teachers for men. They were men of excellent character, free from greed and guiltless, sympathetic to humanities and truthful. Among the many prophets, Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was the first, and Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam is the last and latest prophet. So my dear students, from that introductory sentences you can understood that prophets were the totally sinless. They didn't do any kinds of sin, because if the prophets are our ideal person, prophets are our teacher, prophets are the great men. So if the great men, if the teacher do the wrong deeds, then the follower can say, teachers is doing the wrong deeds, so we can also do that. That's why Almighty Allah didn't give the way for doing the wrong deeds from the prophets and messengers. So they were totally sinless and guiltless, and they were the sympathetic to the human beings, and all kinds of human attributes Almighty Allah gathered in the prophets and messengers. And Almighty Allah selected a lot of prophets, but mentioned in the Quran, in Hadith, 20, in Quran, 25 prophets mentioned Almighty Allah. Among their first prophet was Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, and the last prophet is Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Well, my dear students, now I will discuss about the birth of great prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his identity. When he was born, what was his name, father's name, mother's name, etc. So this is the bonding time. He was born 20th April 570 AD, 12th Rabiul Awwal. This is the Arabic date and month. Students, there is no Arabic year, because Arabic year started after few years. So there is only the day and date, 12th Rabiul Awwal, Monday in Mecca. So many of the information you got in this first line. Okay, what was his father's name? You know, his father's name was Abdullah, mother's name was Amina. Students, keep attention here. I written two type of spelling of Amina, both are correct. Because this one I written, and you will get in your book this spelling. So both you can write. And his grandfather was Abdul Muttalib. After his birth, he was named Muhammad and Ahmad. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's father died before his birth. So it was the identity of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, what was the condition of Arab during the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, during when he was at the time of birth of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what was the condition of Arab? And as you know, the condition of Arab was very, very sad, very horrible. So one by one I will inform you. Number one is, during the born of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the Arab society was no security of life. Drinking wine, taking interest, gambling and other vices were their usual affairs of life. People of Mecca were installed 360 idols in the courtyard of Kaaba. So my dear students, at the time of birth, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, at the time of birth of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the condition of Arab people were very, very horrible. They were engaged in murderous activities. For example, looting, snatching, gambling, robbery, enmity, every kinds of bad deeds, that was their usual affairs. It means they think it's very simple, anytime we can do. So this was the, and there was no security of life. For example, if you come out from your house at the night, then anyone can kill you. Like this, their situation was. Now, what was the condition of women at that time? There was no respect for women either in the family or in the society. Birth of a daughter child was very insulting. They immediately after birth of a daughter used to kill them and dug deep under the soil. People were sold in the market as slaves like goods. So my beloved students, what was the situation of the daughter child? It's very, very dangerous situation. When in any family, in any society was born the daughter, then they was trying to make that secret, or they was trying to kill them under the soil. And they were thinking it was for them, it was the insulting. Why Almighty Allah given the daughter in their family? and people were sold in the market like a goods that can be the male person or the female persons. How we are going to the Meradia hut and we are taking some goods same as people were there. Okay, now number four, in history this period is called Ayyam-e Jahiliyat or the black period or the period of darkness. My beloved students, this sentence is very important. All are important, among them this was more important, because what was the condition of Arab? This period was called the Ayyam-e Jahiliyat, or the another name is the black period, or another name is the period of darkness. You have to remember all these names. Well, now I will discuss the childhood and youth of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I written there 18 information, but if I write, I can write more important information, but I told you already, you have to read your book and you will get more information from the childhood and youth. At first, Abu Lahab's maid servant Shuaiba nourished our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. At second, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was reared to his foster mother Halima of Banu Sa'ad family. Remember this, Halima was the Banu Sa'ad family. It can come in the exam. Number three, Shuaiba, the first foster mother, nursed our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam only for few days, and Halima, second foster mother, reared him up to his 5 years of age. So my dear students, among that three sentences we can realize, at first after bonding of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Shuaiba, who was the maid servant of Abu Lahab, and you know Abu Lahab was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's uncle, at first she reared to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for few days and then taken the duty Hazrat Halima radiallahu ta'ala anha for rearing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that was up to the 5 years of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And number four, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's mother Amina died when he was 6 years old. It means when our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was 6 years old. And then after Amina, he was reared up by his grandfather Abdul Muttalib, but he also died when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was 8 years old. Students, what I written by red ink, all are very important in this sentences. That's why I written in red ink. Number six, at last Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was growing up under the care of his uncle Abu Talib. So students, at first Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's rearing duty was to the Shuaiba for few days, then it was the duty to Halima radiyallahu ta'ala anha, and then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam returned to his mother Amina. But when he was 6 years old, his own mother also died, and then after died of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's mother Amina, the duty was come to his grandfather Abdul Muttalib. But when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was 8 years old, his grandfather Abdul Muttalib also has been died, and at last the duty was come to his uncle Abu Talib, and now Abu Talib was doing his duty. Now what was the condition of Abu Talib? He was very rich or was very poor? Now we will discuss. At last, number seven, the financial condition of Abu Talib was not good. For additional income of the uncle's family, he, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, worked with the cowboys and looked after goats and sheep. As help his uncle business, once Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Syria with his uncle. So when he was growing up by the care of Abu Talib, he was not the lazy boy. I mean, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not the lazy boy, and he was thinking always, I will not the burden to any family. That's why he was thinking, I will do some extra work. That's why he was carrying the Abu Talib's goat and sheep like a cowboys. And then financial condition was growing up of Abu Talib's family. But Also, Abu Talib was a businessman. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also helped in the Abu Talib's business. Okay, now on the way to Syria, he met one Christian clergyman. Clergyman means padri. It means those are performing the duty in the Christian church. They are called clergymen, like the Muslim imam named Bahira. Students, remember this sentence. On the way to Syria, he met one Christian clergyman named Bahira. Bahira termed him as an extraordinary boy and predicted that he, it means Muhammad, would be the last prophet of Allah. And also Bahira warned Abu Talib to be very cautious. Cautious means careful about him. He means Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, because enemies might harm him. So from that sentences we can understood, when Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and Abu Talib was going to the Syria for purpose of the business, on the way they meet one Christian clergyman whose name was Bahira, and he predicted about the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he would be the last prophet. And how the padri informed about Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? He informed from the Taurat, Injil, from that Asmani Kitab, because there is the description about the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And also that padri, that clergyman, cautious to the Abu Talib, many of the people of Makkah, they will be the enemy of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and then they will try to kill the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That's why you should be careful about him. Now, when Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam returned from the Syria to Mecca, what was the condition and what happened there? Now see, gambling in Waqas fair was the root cause of the Fizar war. But Qais tribe imposed this war on the Quraysh tribe. Students, remember, Quraysh tribe was, most of the Quraysh peoples were the good, but Qais tribe imposed, Qais was the not good. They tried to impose means fixed, this war on the Quraysh tribe. Fizar war continued for 5 years. Remember this, it was continued for 5 years. And then many people died and injured. That's why this war was called the War of Injustice or Harbul Fizar. Students, when Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam returned from the Syria to the Mecca, then he was shocked by seeing the horrifying war, only for the in the Waqas fair, only for the gambling. And he was totally shocked, and for this gambling the Fizar war was continued for 5 years, only for simple issue, that is gambling. And then Almighty Allah forbidden the gambling. It's not allowed in Islamic Sharia. At last Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam formed an organization named Hilful Fuzul, or peace organization. Students, Hilful Fuzul means peace organization. For the praiseworthy social works and truthfulness, he got the title of As-Sadiq or Al-Amin. Remember this, why Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam conferred the title As-Sadiq or Al-Amin? Because for the praiseworthy social works. So after seeing the horrifying situation, when the war was stopped, then Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was thinking how we can spread the peace in everywhere. Then he made one organization with the young people, those who had the desire for making the peace everywhere. The organization that was the Hilful Fuzul or peace organization. By seeing these activities of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in everywhere in the society, they were calling him Al-Amin or As-Sadiq. And people kept their valuable wealth or property to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam as Amanud. because they believe about Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam returned their same property or wealth after few days when they need. That's why they are called al-amin or as-sadiq. So my dear students, that was my discussion. I hope you understood, and all the sentences are important. And again, I am telling to you, read these three pages, all lines. So practice at home, stay safe, see you soon inshallah. And there is the HW, my dear students, HW number 11, 15 informative sentences from page 108 to 1110. It means from that three pages you will write 15 informative sentences like this. I written there, all are informative sentences. So same as you will pick up 15 informative sentences. You can follow from this page or you can write from the book as your wish. And this is the lecture number 11. So that's all for today, my dear students. Keep practicing at home. See you soon inshallah. Till then, assalamu alaikum.